our favorite game show countdown. I'm Marianne Faran.
That would make me Steve Saunders.
That's right. Game Show Network invited our viewers to vote for their favorite classic game show.
And now we're revealing their top 10 picks, Marianne.
That's right, we are. And don't forget, you know, we'll be announcing the winner of our sweepstakes at the end of this and sending two very lucky people on an incredible Hawaiian vacation.
All right, well, let's keep things moving. Our viewers voted. Let's see here.
Who's the lucky one?
The $100,000 pyramid with Dick Clark as numero 8.
Numero 8 it is, and here's an episode from 1986. Come on and watch.
Check it out.
From Television City in Hollywood, this is the $100,000 pyramid tournament week. Today's special guests are Sherry Smith and LeVar Burton. Your host is Dick Clark.
Oh! Thank you, Charlie O. We have an anxious group of people here. You want us to give the money away, right? Yes. Oh. There isn't anybody over there that's going to disagree. We have been trying for 3 days to get rid of $100,000, and now's the time, Shelley.
I'm ready to do it. I'll give it to anybody who wants to take
anybody
it.
Anybody
who
yeah. steps
I'll
up.
Okay.
There's a volunteer. Heather Davis, how many times have you played this week? Is this your second time?
This is the second day of the tournament that I'm here, yeah.
Yeah? Well.
And 1 day to get in the tournament.
All right.
And this will be the end of the tournament, this round. Here we go.
This is it. This is the firm resolve. What do you say, Mr. Burton?
I want to cooperate with whoever wants to win the money the most.
All right. We really must bring this to a conclusion, folks. It's too nerve-wracking. Denise Bumbliss, have you been in all of the plays so far, every day we play?
So far.
How are you?
I'm okay.
Okay, don't run down on me now.
No, I'm not. I'm trying to keep my concentration up and get it this time.
Okay, good luck to everybody. The winner's circle awaits you. Now, this time, when you sit in there, the first person to go to the top of the pyramid in 60 seconds or less wins $100,000. Keep watching. We'll see what happens. These are the subjects. It's overdue when Irish eyes are smiling, butterfingers, scared stiff, pigging out, scalpel please. We do not have any bonus situations in this tournament game. Where do we start, Shelley?
Butterfingers.
Describe these things associated with a finger. Okay. Things associated with a finger. Ready, go.
These are brass.
Knuckles.
Uh-huh. And you put it on when you sew.
A thimble.
Right. And you pull it on a gun.
A trigger.
Right. And you get a little piece of wood.
A splinter.
Yeah. And you do this.
Point.
Uh-huh. And it's not a break. It's another thing
it's
like
fracture.
That. Yeah. And you put it around a sore.
A band-aid.
Boo-boo. Yeah.
Band-aid.
All right. 7 out of 7, they've got that time. LeVar Burton, you have 5 subjects.
Pigging out.
These are things associated with a pig.
Right.
Things associated with a pig. Ready, go.
You're not thin, you're
fat.
Mm-hmm. And the sound he makes.
Oink.
Mm-hmm. And this is what you fry in the morning for breakfast.
Bacon.
And this is in your eye.
The sty.
Right. And this is a male blank pig.
Hog.
Male in women's lib. A male.
Chauvinist.
Yes. And these are Jim Henson's thingies.
Muppet.
Yes. And this is a big pig, a male.
Hog.
Yes.
All right. 7-7. It's time. Heather Davis, please, make your selection.
We're going to take Scared Stiff.
All right. Describe for Shelley Smith these things that are scary.
Okay.
Things that are scary. Ready. Go.
This is an evil
monster.
Person. It's a lady with a hat on.
A witch.
A big bad, yeah. And this is a fire-breathing.
Dragon.
Uh-huh. And this is, it's a black bird that goes in the attic.
Go ahead. I'll get it. It's a bat.
He's playing with us. Uh-huh. And this is the movie with Sigourney Weaver.
Alien.
Uh-huh. And this is making a loud
noise.
Yes. And this is do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. The show.
Twilight Zone.
And this is a kind of needle that you shoot up with. I'm really active. I'm really kind of active.
Hypodermic.
Yes.
Yeah.
Not me
I
at all.
I just did that to make it more tense, right?
14-7. Denise.
Scalpel, please.
Scalpel. Describe these words that begin with the letters SC. These words begin with SC. Ready. Go.
You tie this around your neck?
Scarf.
Uh-huh. Your itinerary is also...
Schedule.
Right. A kid doesn't know how to
Scribble.
Write. Right. Act one.
Scene.
Right. What they paint tall buildings with?
Scaffold.
Right. Not shrimp, but little round fish.
Scampi.
No.
A round fish scallop.
Right. And a parchment or a...
A scroll.
Mm-hmm.
It is 14-14.
Oh, my goodness.
We get to 21-21.
Yes.
The only thing remaining from the old game is if we have a 21-21 tie, the tiebreaker wins the $5,000. That's the only little extra wrinkle we have. Where do we go, Shelley?
It's overdue.
All right. Would you like to give or receive?
I'm going to give.
Describe these things associated with the library. Things associated with the library. Okay. Ready. Go.
You go to pre or you go to nursery.
School.
Right. And you do this to your nails.
File.
Uh-huh. And the blank Britannica.
Encyclopedia.
Right. And this is when you bring back a book.
Return.
Uh-huh. And you dial 411.
Emergency information.
Right. And this is in the reading or the novel. These are...
Section.
Right, good. And I'm here, I'm studying something. I'm doing a chemist study.
Thesis, research.
Right.
Yes, that is a perfect score.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Denise Bumbler's handling the screen over there. You're going to give it to LeVar?
Yes.
The screen, right? Describe these things that are Irish. Things that are Irish. You need them all for a tie. Ready? Go.
Not blue, but...
Green.
Yes. And the way they speak is an Irish...
Accent?
Another word for it?
Pass. Can you break it up?
This is what you kiss in Ireland.
The Blarney Stone.
Right. And this is the capital of Ireland, the capital city.
Dublin?
Yes. And this is what you make. It's like a hodgepodge with meat and potatoes. It's all called...
Stew.
Yeah. And this is the four-leaf clover or the...
Good luck?
No, what's it called? The clover, it's called the... The
Heather Davis has won the chance at the $100,000. Okay, Heather, the rooting section is out there for you. I should point out to anybody, if you've missed the last 3 days, you've missed some good ones. In the game as it's played, we play for, I don't know, seems like 6 or 7 weeks, maybe more. We narrow it down to the three people who go to the top of the pyramid in the shortest length of time, whether they're trying for $10,000 or $25,000. Those people with the three shortest time, in this case, Heather Davis, Denise Bumbliss, and Linda Simon, have all done this thing in roughly 30 seconds. It's 29 or 32 seconds to be exact. And the three of them come back and compete day after day until one of them takes the money. That's where we are right now. Are you ready?
Uh-huh.
Look at one another, study everything, get your thoughts together. Just enough energy, but not too much, and we'll pull it off. Everyone in the audience, please, do not say anything. For $100,000, here is your first subject. Go.
Old bread.
These are stale.
Yeah. Two. Boo.
Oh, where's the double O? Where's with the O in it?
The American flag.
Did you salute?
Eagle,
things you're proud. Patriotic things.
Right. Yes. The murky water. The lily pad. The
things that are
dirty
icky,
water.
That you can't. They're dirty. You can't see through.
The dirty
things
fish.
That are
the dirty. The,
polluted. Scummy.
It's scummy water. The
in a fish pond. Things in a lily pond. Things in a in an aquarium.
Fish, the dirt. Okay, let's go on.
Next.
Swamp.
Jack
yes.
and Jill's
with swamp?
Jack and Jill's water.
Things that spill in a pail. Things in a pail.
Right. A college freshman.
Things that are new.
A college fraternity.
Things you pledge. Things you try and get into.
A new job.
Things you apply to.
A college fraternity.
Things.
A fraternity pledge.
Things that are admitted.
What's another word for that?
What do they go through? The blank?
Hell Week.
And then at the end of Hell Week, what happens?
They get in. I don't know.
What does that get in for?
Admission.
In is part of the word. In what?
They put you into the club. What do? They turn around.
Initiate you.
Yes.
Oh,
very close.
Only needed another 2 minutes. We would have gotten it. That is a good score. We came close again. Oh, it's nerve-wracking. $750. We'll be back to play the second round in April. All right, we got them all lined up here, and Heather Davis, our scriptwriter, has won $750. Denise, there's the lady that should be keeping your energy up, because you've been here. You're like a heavyweight, and this is the 14th round you've been battling away. It's going to be your first choice. These are the subjects. We have Turbulent Times, A Ring and a Prayer, Mama Made It, Just for You, Numero Uno, The Rugged Type. Again, there are no bonuses. Shelley picks it and we go.
Mama Made It.
Describe for your partner these things a kid finds in his lunchbox. Okay. Things a kid finds in his lunchbox. Ready, go.
He eats it between bread.
A sandwich?
Yeah. And a potato.
Chips.
Right. And Campbell's cream of tomato.
Soup.
Mm-hmm. And it's orange and a bunny eats it.
A carrot.
Right. And this is a Diet Coke or a Diet...
Soda.
Right. And this is not an apple, but it's shaped like this a little bit.
A pear.
Grows a tree, exactly. And this is not salami, but kind of like...
Bologna?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. 7-0. Perfect score to start this part of the game. LeVar.
Just for you, please.
Just for you is the choice. Describe for Heather these things that are made to order. Things that are made to order. Ready. Go.
This is what a man wears.
Hat.
No,
wig.
Hair.
Toupee.
Uh-huh. And this is what an orthodontist puts on.
Braces.
Mm-hmm. And this is Japanese raw fish.
Sushi.
Mm-hmm. And this is contact.
Lens.
Mm. And an ice cream chocolate, not a banana split.
A sundae.
Right. And your schedule or your daily list of
plan,
events.
Plan, events, errands, itinerary.
Right. And this is what you have an architect draw up. Is...
rendering, drawing, sketching, plan, blueprint.
Yes.
Sure.
Seven-seven.
Denise Bumblitz, there are four choices left.
A ring and a prayer, please.
A ring and a prayer. Describe for Shelley these things associated with the word ring. Okay. These are things associated with the word ring. Ready. Go.
Not silver, but...
Gold.
It gets around the bath.
Tub.
Uh-huh. You answer it, hello?
Telephone.
Mm-hmm. The middle is the...
center.
Right. The diamonds are put in a...
A setting.
Right. The planet with the rings?
A Saturn.
Uh-huh. And a wedding?
Engagement ring, a wedding cake.
The actual
ceremony.
Right.
Yes. It'll be a perfect game. 14-7 so far. Turbulent Times, numero uno, the rugged type. What'll it be, Heather?
Numero uno.
Describe these things that contain or include Roman numerals. Yes. Things that contain or include Roman numerals. Ready, go.
You tell time on your...
Watch.
Uh-huh. And you have all the months
calendar.
Are on the... Mm-hmm. And you get this to go to a party. Someone
an
wants
invitation.
You to come. Yeah. And you take out... You want to rent a place. You sign a...
A lease.
Uh-huh. And this is the name on the front of a book. It's the...
The title.
Uh-huh. And the book is broken into lots of...
Chapters.
Uh-huh. And this is the king who had all his wives killed.
Midas.
Had all his wives
Henry
killed.
Henry VIII.
Yes.
Yes, it's 14-14. We could be headed for a tie game.
The big fat guy.
Get to a tie, break the tie, somebody wins 5,000. Shelley?
Turbulent Times, I'm going to give.
Describe these things that make waves.
Okay.
Things that make waves. Ready, go.
Not the sun, but the...
The moon.
Mm-hmm. And Jonah was swallowed by
a whale.
Mm-hmm. And you row with an...
An oar.
Right. And I'm going to tell you a piece of news. It's a hot piece of...
A gossip?
Right.
Secret.
And I get a blank wave in my hair.
Permanent.
Right. And this is a, you know, a thunder blank...
Storm.
Right. And this is a famous show with Morley Safer and Dan Rather. It's...
60 Minutes.
Right.
That's it. That's a perfect game. We're headed for a tie, perhaps. 21-21 means a $5,000 bonus. Who on the other side will give, LeVar? Describe these rough and tough guys. Rough okay. and tough guys. They need 21 points for the tie. Ready. Go.
Sylvester Stallone played this.
Rocky.
Yes. And 007 is?
James Bond.
Right. And I Pity the Fool.
Mr. T.
Right. And Miami Vice, not the...
John Johnson.
Yes. And old-time gangster, the St. Valentine...
Al Capone.
Yes, thank you. And Dirty Harry.
Clint Eastwood.
Yes. And the other guy, the tough guy...
John Johnson.
Yes! Yeah. You are the luckiest man alive.
That was pure skill.
No way, talent. You give her a clue, the other tough guy. Shame on you. I mean, your heads were really together. Right, calm. Let's go. Break the tie. Somebody will win $5,000. LeVar and Heather. Words that begin with the letter R or the letter D.
D.
D it is. You'll give?
Yes.
Describe these words that begin with the letter D. Ready, go.
This is the flaky stuff in your
Dana.
Hair. Mm-hmm. And this is cheese, milk.
Dana, dairy.
Yes. And this is what you get at the end of graduation. Your
diploma.
Right. And this is laundry soap.
Detergent.
Right. And this is where you go to get a skin thing. The skin
dermatologist.
Yes. And this is a nick in your car or a...
Yes.
Yes. And this is a knife or
a dagger.
Yes.
That's it. We'll take their time, 22 seconds, flip it over the other side, and Shelley, you will give. You've got to come up with 7 out of 7 in less than 22 seconds. The person who breaks this tie wins $5,000. These are words that begin with the letter R. Ready, go.
A bunny.
Rabbit.
Uh-huh. And he's a mechanical man, a...
A robot.
Right. And you shave with a...
Razor.
Right. And this is what you put on with ketchup on a hamburger. It's green.
Relish.
Right. And this is the guy who's like an umpire at a football game.
Referee.
Right. And this is what you ride on the blank road with a locomotive on the...
Railroad.
Right. And this is what you ask for in a kidnapping, the money.
Ransom.
Right.
You got it! Denise Bumpers just won $5,000 and another shot at $100,000. Very good. This is the sixth time that Denise Bumblis has been in this winner's circle trying to win the $100,000. Shelley was all pent up and nervous from the last round. You calm down now?
A little bit more. Those tiebreakers are just killers.
Yeah. You want to be peppy, full of energy. Peppy. There's a word they don't use much anymore. My grandmother used to say peppy. Anyway, you want to be up,
right,
but not too far up because you don't want to get crazed with this thing. All right. I'll give you the silent treatment. We haven't done that in a while. We'll just let you sit there quietly for about 5 seconds. Catch your breath. I'll remind everybody in the audience, please do not talk to one another while this is going on for 60 seconds. Everybody nice and quiet. Give them a couple of seconds to think. All right. For $100,000, here's your first subject. And go.
His funny red nose.
What a clown you
did. Yes. The hoop. The nine players, the six players.
The parts of a basketball.
The hoop, yeah.
Field, team.
Paris, London, the dentist's office.
Place you visit.
Yes, right. Herring.
Types of fish?
Herring. Peppers. Jack's peppers.
Things that are pickled,
right. A big nose. Dolly Parton's chest.
Things that are prominent. Things that are big. Things
Dolly Parton's long. Chest.
Things that stick out. Things that
mm-hmm.
protrude.
Mm-hmm.
Hurry, Shelley.
Old-fashioned Japanese women's feet.
Things that are bound.
You just...
Yeah! Let's move over here. There you go. This way. That's the chair. Over here. Come on, guys. Don't fall off the shot. Okay, leave me a hole right here. Denise, sit down. We brought a few of your intimate friends up from the audience. This is the immediate family joining us now. Do you have relatives here?
Yes, I do. This is my husband, Brian.
Why don't you swing around inside here and everybody else? Just keep the shot open here, folks. Please do me. Just back up a smidgen. Anybody else?
And this is my mom, Helen.
Hi, how are you? Is there anything you would like to... Oh, yes, I'll get
my
this
kids.
On. Is there anything you want to say to these two lovely people who work so hard?
I could not have asked for better help and better partners in this game. They are the best, and I appreciate every single word they said.
All right, now I have a little... Where's my camera that's usually over there? He's gone. How about this fellow right here? Now, name these kids that you've been holding in your hand all this time.
The one on the far right is Dale. Jeff's in the middle, and the baby is Brian, but we call him Bubba because he's precious.
There you are. Good guys. Congratulations. You won $100,000. We'll be right back. Yeah. $1,000 pyramid with Linda Simon, won $50,750, a car, and a trip to Hong Kong. Shelley, thank you. LeVar, thank you. Good work. Denise, your final total is $118,600 and a trip to Rio. You had 7 seconds left on the clock. Heather Davis, you are going to be with us again tomorrow because you were the last winner in that last tournament. You could win again. You're up to $11,450. We'll see you tomorrow, folks. Terrific. We'll see you then. Thank you all so very much. For now, Dick Clark. Hello.
Some of our contestants will receive...
It's Super Password. Our special guest this week, Phyllis Diller. And from Murder, She Wrote, Ron Mason. And the star of Super Password, Burt Cumbie.
Thank you. Hi, thank you. Hello there. Here we go. 50. Hi, welcome. Welcome to Super Password. Great, as always, to have you here. Thank you so much. It's probably for Ron. You look very nice, and you look spectacular. Wow. The colors, I mean, it just...
This is my skin.
Oh. I'm sorry. You've got a nasty rash then, haven't you?
I do.
How are you, Phyllis?
I'm perfect.
How was your sister? You know, the one that...
TRAMP? Well, she just won the Dr. Ruth Lifetime Achievement Award.
She did, eh?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Joan Collins calls her a slut. Oh,
that's how bad she is,
She has a wonderful life.
Yeah, she does, huh?
Yep, I've changed the tires on my car 8 times, and she's never changed hers once. She's had it reupholstered.
A few times. Didn't she have trouble learning to drive, in fact?
Yeah, it took a driving instructor 3 days to teach her how to sit up in a car.
Yeah, I've heard about her. See, everybody here knows her. All the guys on the crew.
Of course they know her.
Everybody.
Our Navy listener is a friendly port. She spent more time with the Rams than the coach.
Okay. We'll get back to her adventures again, because I never get tired of hearing about your sister. Ron, have you got any sisters, brothers?
Yes.
Well, thank you for sharing.
I'm very proud. My daughter, my eldest daughter, is managing a group of recording artists called Mirage. Rick Dees just played their song, and it became the most requested song on the radio this week. It's called Can't Stop Now, and I'm so proud of her.
Oh, that's wonderful. She's a personal manager. She's no kidding. She should manage you.
Yeah, she should.
Deal.
No, she's in the music. Rick Gerard recordings and things like that.
I see, yeah. Okay, well, that's
just a father.
And you're proud.
She doesn't know what I do for a living.
Yeah. She certainly does. She watches you on Murder, She Wrote, and so do I. And so does half of America. More than half, actually.
Yeah.
Where are we? We have Gina and Al. Gina and Al, I don't want to mispronounce your name again. I did it once already. Welcome again, and tell us something about yourself before we start.
My name is Gina Francis, and I live in Los Angeles, and I'm a receptionist. Hello, may I help you?
You're a receptionist at a major what? Because everybody's always at a major...
Yeah, this is a dump.
Oh, it's a dump.
Excuse me, I was a receptionist.
Jenna's a receptionist.
Now I'm looking for employment.
At a major dump. Thank you, Jenna.
I feel like I could be in the middle of sweeps week somewhere.
All right, here's Al. Big Al from the gold mining country. Big Al's got a straight $7,000 right now. $7,000. Jenna just yelled out, "That's enough." Okay.
So what's so good about him? She's a gold digger.
Whoa. Not bad, not bad.
I'm Al Ballard, gold miner from Helena, Montana. And being a gold miner doesn't mean that you're rich. We're struggling. We work very hard. We've been at it 8 years. And I just came down to California to be on Password, Super Password. And I've really enjoyed it.
Well,
we've got wonderful people here, and they're great to deal with. They're a lot of fun, and it's really neat.
Oh, that's nice for you to say. Thank you, Al. I agree with you.
I wish I said that.
Yeah, no, I agree with you. You're really right. We're going to miss him. Okay, so here we Joyce is over there saying, is he kidding? This is a $200 puzzle. The cash was worth $1,000. If you're ready to go, Al and Jenna giving the clues, and here comes the first word of it, please. Jenna.
This word is sexy.
Alluring.
Sexy.
Yeah. Jenna, take that sweater right off of you.
That's it. Sexy.
Sexy on the board, Ron.
Sexy is on the board. Scott Feinstein.
Remember him well.
He's my sexy accountant.
Oh, thank you very much. This is Scott Feinstein. I knew there was a connection somewhere.
Sexy. I mean, that's you. Yeah. I could have gone right for you, Bert.
Thank you.
But they'd have thought it
but
was...
But you didn't.
Now, set up.
Next word, please.
If it says sexy guy, I'll go for you.
Thank you very much, Scott.
That's what he's been.
Jenna?
Sleep.
Dream.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mattress.
Slumber.
Mm-hmm. Gina?
Mattress.
Blanket.
Al?
Furniture.
Recliner.
Oh, boy. Oh, you're right.
It
is a recliner. We're looking for a bed.
Bed.
Yeah, we'll put it on the boards. We have a sexy bed on the board.
Sexy bed.
Yes, ma'am. Next word, if you please, sir.
Password is...
There it is. Gina.
Quartered.
Sectional.
Mm-hmm. Al?
Quarter.
Half.
Yes, very good. Yeah, that was good. Sexy, bed, and half. Phyllis?
Twin.
Is it twin? Oh, it's a good guess. I don't know where we're going here, do you?
Really,
I have no idea. Next word, please.
Joan Collins.
Probably is, again. Al?
Conch.
Shell.
Yeah, oh boy. Sexy, bed, half, shell. Phyllis?
A date.
Is it a date? You all know what it is up here?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what it is. I feel so... Next word, please.
The password is food.
Al.
Edible.
Eat.
Jenna.
Chicken.
Food.
Yep.
Yes!
I know what it is!
Sexy, fed, half-shell food, Ron.
I know what it is, but I'm afraid to tell you.
What is it?
She'd like to jump all over my... Oyster.
Is it oyster?
Give him money.
Jenna has $200. Al has $100. And we'll be back in a moment after this message for you. Jenna has $200 and Al has $100. It is time for the cash word. Ron, you get it again.
Okay.
You're very good at this cash word. Very good. Take a look at it, sir. It's worth $1,000 to Jenna. And Gina's telling everybody what it is.
Sprout.
Okay. We're ready for the first of three clues, sir.
Bean.
Kidney.
Second clue.
Short.
Lima.
Third clue.
Green.
String.
Oh, there's such a big clue. Brussels.
Sprout?
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, easy for you.
I'm sorry.
You're legendary.
I thought you were going to say that. I thought you were going to say bean or vegetable and then say
I never think of Brussels sprout as a bean.
It's not, I don't think.
I think of bean sprouts as beans.
That's where you were going. I
think
that.
Of Brussels in Belgium.
You'd have gotten it.
Or do I feel dumb?
No, not at all. I just happen to have a good one for it. I seldom do. Okay, next time cash is worth $2,000, and Jenna, you might have another shot at it.
That's okay.
And not only that, the score now, Jenna has $200 and now has a heart. We'll change places. Breakaway, very briefly, come back by
somewhere. I'm sorry, Jenna.
I didn't mean to make you feel bad there, sir.
I don't, I never feel bad. You're absolutely right.
We did that. Maybe we did 5 minutes on it. It was great. It was really funny. Okay, we're back. We're back. We want to tell you, you can come down here and be a contestant on our show. We have $25,000 up for grabs over there. We're not going to tell you about San Diego today, though. I mean, if you want to be a contestant and you live in San Diego, this is not for you, although you probably still could. But we're going to talk about contestants who are in Los Angeles, who are going to be in Los Angeles. But if you live in San Diego and you're coming to Los Angeles, then you can use this phone number. Otherwise, use the phone number we told you about yesterday if you live in San Diego. Here's Gene Wood.
If you would like to be a contestant on Super Password, in L.A., dial area code 213-965-1111. In San Diego, dial area code 619-223-2101. Some participants of Super Password may receive Polonis, the original ceramic heater, the amazing 6-inch cube that can economically heat even an average living room. Furnished by Polonis Safety Furnace. Back to Bert.
Good game, not funny. Okay. Okay, thank you for that message, Gene. We appreciate it. Jenna has $200, and Al has $100. Excuse me. This is a $300 puzzle, so let's go to it. Phyllis, you and Ron are giving the clues. Here comes the first word, please.
Who goes first?
The password
Ron
is
does.
Shiny.
I go first?
Mm-hmm.
Polished.
Waxed?
Mm-hmm.
Phyllis?
Slick.
Shiny?
You bet. Very nice clue, Phyllis. Really good clue. Shiny. Jenna, for the game.
My forehead.
Is it your forehead? Okay. Why not? Take a shot.
Better than Scott Feinstein.
Yes. Here we go. Next word, please.
The password is
right,
chest.
Thorax.
What? Medicine?
Oh, it's a great clue.
What did she say?
Thorax. Ron?
Pectorals.
Muscles?
Mm-hmm. Phyllis?
Bust. Chest?
Yes, there you go. Smart lady. Shiny? We have a shiny chest.
Is it Arnold Schwarzenegger?
For the game, is it Arnold Schwarzenegger? Whoa.
Yes,
he does.
Oh.
Yeah, very
shiny. They make him shave.
Yeah, probably greases up a little, probably. Why? Okay, next
grease.
Word, please.
A lot of grease.
The password is sheriff.
Gina? I mean, Phyllis, I'm sorry.
Oh, dear. Oh, law.
Well, she said law. We can go ahead and allow that.
Legal?
Mm-hmm. Ron?
Marshall?
Sheriff?
Yeah. Yeah. Shiny chest and sheriff, sir.
How about, maybe could it be a badge?
Is it badge? Gotta be.
That's what I said. It's not a
Whoa.
Badge.
Oh, wow. Fooled me. Next word, please. Yipes.
The password is badge.
Ron?
Emblem?
Badge.
Yep. Try it again. Shiny chest, sheriff, and badge, Al.
Is it Murder, She Wrote?
Is it Murder, She Wrote?
But right. Thanks anyhow, Al.
All right, here we go. Next word, please.
The password is shame.
Uh-huh. Ron?
Configuration.
Star?
Phyllis?
Body.
Emblem.
Ron?
Contour.
Shape.
Yep. That's the way. Shiny chest, sheriff, badge, and shape, Al.
This time, let's try, is it a star?
Is it a star? Yeah. $400. Jenna has $200. We're going to break away very briefly and come back and find out who goes over and plays for $25,000. Don't go away. See you in a minute. Yeah, we're is up to, let's guess it now.
See.
I know you do. Well, that we're talking about, if you play the board too early, too, it can really throw you. You got to get here first. Okay, Al has $400. Jenna has $200. This is the $400 puzzle. This will definitely decide who goes over and plays for the big hunk of money on the end. All right? Jenna and Al, given the clues, here comes your first word.
The password is young.
Jenna, there it is.
Old?
Young.
Yes. All right. Young on the board. Phyllis? For the game.
The young and the restless.
Is it the young and the restless? No, probably
the
not.
The old and the listless.
Yes.
No, but you're close. I have a new TV show, a soap coming up, The Old and the Breastless.
Oh, that's good. That's good. I've always thought they should do it in space and call it The Young and the Weightless, but probably won't happen.
How times have changed. I remember when we couldn't say darn Yankees.
That's right. That's right. I remember that, too. All right, here we go. Next word, please. Where are we?
Yeah. The password is Camelot.
Jenna?
Musical.
It's one I don't know.
Whoa. But you sang the song. Well.
Arthur?
Camelot.
Yep. Camelot. Young Camelot. For the game, Ron.
Pud?
What?
What the heck is his name?
Pud? I think that's your answer.
Pud's my answer.
Yes. Is it Pud?
Is he an accountant?
That's the name of somebody in some book somewhere.
Yes, I think so. Here we go. Next word.
Yeah, Pud?
You probably meant Puck. Here we go.
The password is Boston.
Whoa.
I knew that,
Jenna.
I knew it.
What did they
no,
give anything?
Nothing happened. No,
was it not one word?
Not
passed?
A word was passed between
them.
They
just silent?
They just sat there totally quiet.
I love it.
Yeah.
Massachusetts.
Boston.
Yep. Young. Camelot. Boston. For the game.
Yale.
Is it Yale?
I know what it is now.
No, you know.
Now I know.
Okay, here we go. Next word, please.
Password is Jackie.
Okay, Gina?
Ouch.
Sorry. Ow, you hit your knee on that?
Yeah.
Onassis.
Jackie.
Yep. Great coach. Young, Camelot, Boston, and Jackie for the game, Phyllis.
The Kennedys.
Is it the Kennedys? Okay, don't say anything more now. Here we go, last word.
Last word is president.
All right, Gina.
Reagan.
President.
Yes. Young, Camelot, Boston, Jackie, and president for the game.
JFK.
Is it JFK? Yes. Oh, I didn't know that. All right. Congratulations to Jenna. She's our new champ. Are you all right? Jenna?
No.
Be calm. Be calm.
No.
Al has to leave us now, but Al, you've won $7,300. Not so bad. Congratulations.
It was great.
We're going to break away and come back, and then Phyllis and Jenna are going to go over and play for $25,000. Should be fun. See you in a moment.
I don't believe it.
We're back. I'm here with Phyllis and Jenna. And Jenna, you picked a great time to come. It's okay. You can. It doesn't matter. Whatever you feel like doing, be relaxed and be cool. I'm going to give you 10 words beginning with L and going through you. L through you. Everyone you get right, I'll give you $100. And if you get all 10 right, I'll give you $25,000.
Okay.
60 seconds, Phyllis.
Can you see?
It starts with L.
L.
Yes.
L.
And you look, it'll be in that little box right down there. Okay? Here we go. Good luck. Oh, wait, you got to put your first word up.
Oh, yeah.
All right, you got it? Don't say anything yet. Good luck. Ready? And
books,
go.
Books.
Literature.
Building.
A library.
M.
Ketchup.
Mustard.
N.
Eat. Chew. Rabbit.
Nibble.
O.
Band.
Organ.
Symphony.
Orchestra.
P.
House, do, color, brush, pass.
Q.
Bird.
Quail.
R.
Square.
Round.
Square. Square.
Rectangle.
S.
Bed. Linen.
Sheets.
T.
Sew. Finger.
Thimble.
U.
Play. Strings.
Ukulele.
P.
House. Color. Liquid.
Pink.
Liquid. Liquid. Do. Over. Brush.
Paint.
Yes! One second left. Can you believe it? Are you full?
I won. Phyllis,
don't leave us, Phyllis.
No.
We want to keep going, but we're out of the
hole.
Yes, we're going to keep going here. Are you ready to cross back? I'm going to carry Jenna back. She now has $25,600.
I'm going to carry Phyllis back.
No,
I'll carry
go.
The money you want.
Carry the money.
Take the money. Let's go. Okay, here we go. Have a seat. Have a seat.
Brilliant. Brilliant.
Jenna, have a seat.
Oh, my God! Oh, my God!
Jenna, are you going to be okay?
No!
Let's get some water for this girl.
One.
Here.
Jenna, put it in my
second.
Face.
No,
one
no, no.
Second.
Jenna, take some water. Don't worry about a thing.
One
you're going to be just,
second.
You're going to be fine.
Hi, hi, hi.
You can keep it. Just keep it. Just take it there.
Yeah, baby.
Yeah.
I don't want to be in the room.
Well,
is this
I,
your cup first?
Yes, you may have that.
I can have anything I want. I've got $25,000.
That's true. You can. You can have your own show, and you may have, as a matter of fact. We have no more time left. We're going to put Jenna to bed now. We'll see you tomorrow.
I hope
you'll be back.
We've
thank
only
you.
Just met.
Bye, everybody.
It's Toad. Toad. I'm going to explain that.
Later today on Days of Our Lives, what has Roman learned about Marlena's death that can only bring pain to Diana? Find out today on NBC.
This is Gene Woods speaking for Super Patchwork, a Mark Goodson television production.